like you to think of as many questions as you can on either by a presentation or what we're doing, because we're gonna go in front of a panel of judges and they're gonna sit there and drill us for a while on some questions. So if you think of any, just write them down or go on the question section, you can answer them at the end. And then this is gonna be about 5 minutes, it's gonna be a lot of information, so if you don't understand something, we need to know, or it'd be great to know. So welcome, my name is Tanner Blank. This is John Eggers, Joseph Cadden, Nick Smith, and Matt Kern, and we're from the Electrical Trades Department. Our entry is electrical automation to solve hunger, and this project will be put in place to solve world insecurity. According to DoSomething.org, Charity Foundation, about 1 in 6 people face hunger every day. In 2013, 17.5 million households were food insecure. 49 million Americans struggle to put food on the table for their families, and 795 million people do not have enough food to live a healthy and active lifestyle. If we were to look around the room, that would mean every 9th person in this room would be food insecure. At our school, many students go home and wonder where they're gonna get their next meal. So we decided to try and solve this problem. As a team, we came together to find a solution to solve food insecurity. It allowed us to use the skills we had acquired through our education. After some research, we decided on aquaponics. Aquaponics is a crop growing system that combines conventional aquaculture, which is the raising of aquatic animals for food, so basically fish to eat, and hydroponics, which is the cultivating plants in water by manipulating growing chemicals, so adding fish waste to water and then watering plants. This process is completed by pumping the byproducts of raising fish into grow beds filled with growing media. As bacteria grows in the growth media, it turns the ammonia from the fish waste into nitrates, which the plants use to grow. The plants also need light in order to photosynthesize. After our initial research concluded, we moved into the prototype stage. From conception, we focused on building our prototype low cost, basic, and with as little human involvement as possible. We want our system to basically set it and forget it. And here's where electrical automation really comes to the front of this project. So, the only human involvement is the push of a start button. The push button sends a signal into our control system that starts the process of cycling fish waste filled water through the grow beds, where it is filtered and taken back through the nitrification process and returned back into the fish tank. The cycling of water cleans and removes the ammonia from the fish waste. The same start signal also engages our lighting system. We have the lighting system programmed to act like the sun moving through the sky. So to show you how fast it works, we planted seeds on a Thursday and had seedlings by the following Monday. Through the grow process, we identified limitations with our system, and this led to the development of Aqua 2.0. We have increased the technology in our control lighting systems, as well as increased our growing areas. One issue we sought to overcome was with the aquaculture side of things. Our first system housed only common goldfish and fathead minnows. Our first system also only had our 50-gallon tank capacity, and we upgraded to a 275-gallon tank, which we will use to grow blue tilapia and close the loop on the system. The blue tilapia will actually eat the leaves and vegetables from our system, further closing that cycle. The lighting technology is incorporated in our cycle, incorporates light wavelengths and allows us to manipulate the wavelengths to create recipes for each crop that we're growing. This technology allows us to also be more energy efficient. For Aqua 2.0, the process remains the same, and now we seek to drive for a system that is energy neutral. So how can our system benefit most people and contribute to the community's needs? Through the design and improvement of the process, we start to realize this could really make a difference. We're now looking towards the future. We believe the utilization of a geodesic dome to house a scaled-up version of our system can be implemented into our community, across the nation, and the world. We have identified a process that community can use minimal effort and resources to gain access to fresh foods and vegetables, and also fresh food, fish to eat. We seek to utilize renewable energy systems to offset the consumption, process consumption, and rain collection systems to offset the water loss. We have identified a solution to help solve food insecurity issues not only in our community, but if done correctly, around the world. We put a lot of work into this project, and it's been a labor of love, and we will continue to refine it to get the best possible results as possible. We hope that one day we can see a system implemented in communities around the world.